More than 31 million users' data has been exposed in a cyber attack on the Internet Archive, a cornerstone of digital history preservation.
Если несправедливость стала законом, то пусть восстание станет долгом. 28 мая мы начали международную атаку на крупнейший в мире архив, которая длилась много часов. Атака была проведена дважды, и мы взяли на себя полную ответственность за это.
Hey everyone, Yaniv Hoffman here, back with another video, and today we are diving into something that is alarming as it is real. Imagine waking up one day to find that history itself is starting to disappear. Not through a catastrophic event or the loss of an ancient document, but through something more insidious. Hackers systematically rewriting and erasing digital history. This is not a movie plot, this is reality that has played out multiple times in the shadowy corners of the internet. So the Internet Archive, home to billions of web pages from across decades, is one of the most valuable digital repositories in existence. You might know it by its most famous tool or website, the Wayback Machine. This website allows anyone to access snapshots of websites showing what they look like 10, 20 years ago, actually since 1996. But recently, this treasure trove of digital history has become a prime target for hackers. And in today's video, we are going to look at the recent attacks on the Internet Archives by several hacking groups. We'll speak how these attacks are more than just political, affecting journalists, researchers, and public access to historical records. And we will also explore how these attacks were executed, including DDoS defacements and possible data breaches. Actually, not possible, confirmed data breaches. And finally, we will dive into how the Internet Archive has responded, upgrading their systems, and the future of digital history protection, if we will have the time. So let's get started and break down what's really going on with these cyber attacks and why they matter more than ever. For most of us, archives like the Internet Archive are passive, quiet observers of history. They silently collect and store vast amounts of information without us even knowing. A page saved 5 or 10 years ago, it's likely still there today, preserving content that has long disappeared from the archive web. This kind of digital preservation is incredibly important, not just for historians, journalists, and legal researchers, but for anyone who cares about transparency and accountability in the digital age. And here easily you can use the Wayback Machine to access historical snapshots of websites. You can follow along on the screen to see how easy it is to view the past outline. So first, visit the Wayback Machine, go to archives.org/web, enter a URL in the search bar, type the URL of the website you want to view, in it archived, in example, amazon.com, as I use, select a year. Once you enter the URL, the Wayback Machine will show you a timeline with available snapshots. And then select the year you are interested in from the timeline, choose a date, click on a specific date on the calendar to see how the website looked at the particular day. And the Wayback Machine will load the saved version of the website, allowing you to browse it as it was on the selected date. This powerful tool makes the past accessible to everyone, but it's also what makes Internet Archives such an attractive target for hackers. So let's look at the chain of events in the 2024 attacks. So on September 30th, 2024, suspicious activity was first reported at the Internet Archive. But it wasn't until October 5 that it was confirmed as a serious breach, and security researcher Troy Hunt, founder of Have I Been Pwned, received a 6.4 gigabyte SQL file from the attackers containing email addresses, a bcrypt hash password, and other data. Hunt confirmed the authenticity of the data, stating that it was indeed real. This only escalated the severity of the breach as it exposed sensitive information belonging to 31 million users. The day after, by October 6, the Internet Archive was notified of the issue, although it had not yet been made public. Then on October 8, a distributed denial of service attack, a DDoS attack, began targeting the archive's servers. Finally, on October 10, the Internet Archive website was completely taken offline. And Bleeping Computer wrote a detailed article on this breach confirming that the compromised data included login credentials and personal details for millions of users. This has raised major concerns about how the Internet Archive will secure its systems moving forward. Now, as I mentioned before, the Internet Archive contains over 890 billion web pages and houses around 99 petabytes of data. To put this into perspective, if you were to view one web page every second, it would take over 28,000 years to view all of the web pages stored in the archive. This staggering volume of data demonstrates both the importance and vulnerability of such a massive collection of digital history. To take a step back before we speak about the attack, let's know the founder and the man behind the archive. And his name is Brewster Kahle, and he's the founder of Internet Archive, and he's the key figure in digital preservation since its inception in 1996. He's a digital librarian. Kahle has been passionate about ensuring that the vast expansion of the Internet remains accessible to everyone, even long after pages disappeared from the active web. He faced enormous pressure during the October 2024 attack and confirmed that while the DDoS attacks were disruptive, the data in the archives remained safe. Kahle also reassured users that the archive is working on restoring services and improving security. At the date of this video, Internet Archive are up. Now, the attacks on the Internet Archives in 2024 are not new. And in 2010, a hacker group targeting the Internet Archive launched a distributed denial of service attack. Their objective was not to steal data or ask for ransom, but to make the entire archive inaccessible. The attackers later traced back to an unknown group of activists, flooded the archive servers with overwhelming traffic, causing them to crash repeatedly over several days. To the casual internet user, it might have seemed like a simple website outage, but the implications were enormous. And this wasn't the first time the Internet Archive had been attacked, but it was the first time the attack appeared coordinated. The motivation behind it? To disrupt the easy access to historical snapshots of web pages, which some activists claimed were being used by governments and corporations to cover up the past. But in reality, the damage hurt independent researchers and journalists the most, many of whom relied on these archives to preserve accurate records of political statements, scientific research, and other critical information. So a hacker group called SN Black Meta took responsibility for a recent attack on the Internet Archive. On October 10, the group posted on X, formerly Twitter, and Telegram, claiming the attack was a protest against the preserved ties between the archive and geopolitical issues. Their message stated, "The Internet Archive is suffering from a devastating attack." They follow up with a video, an additional post on Telegram, further explaining their motivations. Let's see it again.
Вы не определяете нашу ценность или кто мы. Важны наши цели. Мой ответ – видеть, а не слышать.
So while Black Meta claimed responsibility, their role is not fully confirmed, and there is a possibility that another group may have been involved in the data theft. The primary reason for this doubt stems from the nature of the attack and the group's motivation. While Black Meta has been vocal about political motives, researchers believe the actual breach, which exposed sensitive data of 31 million users, may have involved different actors. Some analysts suggest the DDoS attacks and defacement by Black Meta could be more of an attention-seeking move, separate from the more sophisticated data breach that remains under investigation. Now, the Internet Archive itself acknowledged the DDoS and defacement, but has not confirmed that Black Meta was responsible for the entire breach, which involved accessing Azure credential found in information stealer log. This suggests the actual breach may have been opportunistic or carried out by a different group, leveraging these credentials. So as I mentioned before, in recent years, hacker groups like Black Meta and Anonymous Sudan have gained notoriety for their attempts to attack and manipulate the Internet Archive. Black Meta in particular presents itself as a pro-Palestinian group, but research shows it operates primarily out of Russia. Now, this group has been linked to multiple DDoS incidents and defacement campaigns aimed at disrupting or altering archived content. Anonymous Sudan, another group responsible for large-scale DDoS attacks, has disrupted access to the Internet Archive during political sensitive periods. These attacks often coincide with global events, making it difficult for researchers and journalists to access historical records during times of civil unrest or elections. So while these groups claim to be motivated by political or ideological reasons, their actions have far-reaching consequences. By undermining the accessibility of digital archives, they make it increasingly difficult to trust the integrity of historical records, which researchers, journalists, and the public rely on factual information. So in recent months, security researchers have noted significant overlap between Black Meta and Anonymous Sudan. These two groups share similar ideological motivation, particularly their pro-Palestinian stance, and have employed comparable attack methods, including DDoS and defacements. Analysts have observed a drop in activity from Anonymous Sudan around the same time Black Meta emerged, suggesting that they could be operating as part of the same group or under closely aligned leadership. Their targets and messaging have also been similar, with both groups focusing on high-profile anti-Western cyber attacks. So we talked about the hackers themselves, but what about the methods? And the methods the hackers use to attack Internet archives vary depending on their goals. And let's break down the most common types of the attack. The first one is the DDoS distributed denial of service attacks. And this is the most straightforward attack where hackers overwhelm a website server with the fake traffic causing it to crash. The goal is not to change the data, but to make the archive unavailable. This kind of attack often serves as a distraction while hackers try to move invasive methods of manipulating content behind the scene. So this was used against the Internet Archive, which was down for a few hours. The second type of attack is defacement, and it involves altering the content of an archived page, making it display false or misleading information. And this can be as simple as changing the text or images on the page, or as sophisticated as injecting malicious code that executes when the page is accessed. Think about hackers that are replacing factual data with politically charged misinformation. And this type of attack can be incredibly dangerous as it casts doubt on the reliability of archived records. The third type is data manipulation or injection attacks. And this is when hackers inject or modify archived content to alter its historical record. Now, unlike defacement, which is usually more visible and intended to disrupt, data manipulation can go unnoticed for years, only to be discovered when the manipulated data is used in research or legal proceedings. One particularly sneaky method hackers use is SQL injection, the old and the good one, where they exploit vulnerabilities in the archive's database to introduce or alter records. And this kind of attack is harder to detect because it doesn't immediately disrupt the functionality of the archive. It just silently changes the data. Okay, so let's start to summarize. So in response to the breach, the Internet Archive disabled the vulnerable JavaScript library that had been exploited in the attack and implemented significant security upgrades. These upgrades include strengthening encryption protocol and enhancing content validation system to detect any tampering in the archives earlier. Additionally, the archive has ramped up defenses against further DDoS attacks. So to conclude, the battle to protect Internet archives is far from over. As we move further into the digital age, these archives will only become more important, serving as the last line of defense against the erasure or manipulation of our online history. Hackers know this and they will continue to target these repositories for their own gain. But with the right security measures and proactive approach, we can ensure that the web's memory remains intact for us and for future generations. So if you enjoyed this video and want to see more content like this, feel free to leave a comment in the description below. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. It only takes a second, and hit the like button. These small actions help the algorithm promote the video and give me more exposure. Thanks for watching and see you in the next time.